choking himself at the time.
Shorty pisses through that hole on your.
This is a bully positive environment. Cut.
Let's go, come on. Go. Squeeze. Let's go. Come on. Let's go. Oh, this one's fucking painful, eh?
Damn.
You feel like this one's gonna tear some shit almost sometimes?
Sorry.
On me it does. I think it's feels fucking awkward on me.
Really?
I always feel like I'm gonna.
Mine's not that bad.
I always feel like I'm gonna tear some shit on this one.
This one's worse.
Guys, Vanquish, 80% off right now for the Easter sale. I don't know when this shit fucking ends, but everything is up to 80% off. And if you use code Devin, you get an additional 10% off. So it's for some of the shit, it's gonna be like literally 90% off. So, you know, hit the link, guys. We got a Dragon Ball Z drop coming March 28th. So this is one of the oversized tees that's dropping. Pretty fire, so get on it, baby. I really just gotta pull up that old 28 grams album. Get that zip off. It's fucking cool. You wanna know what I listened to in high school? Go there, baby.
Yeah. Oh, here we go.
Fucking rough on the shoulder.
Go. Come on.
So weak.
Weak?
Yeah.
I know, my strength is fucking horrible today.
I don't think I can do two.
My strength's fucking dust. I'm fucking weak as shit.
Oh, look, they got a new little weight rack here. It's fucking convenient. There was a time I was doing four plates on that bitch. Like, you don't even have a buck. But the thing is, I think we usually put it at five, that setting there. So it's not, it doesn't start as far back. Actually, it's fucking coughing and shit.
Fuck.
You're disgusting. You know, guys, my chest is fucking tight right now. Oh, here we go. Fucking Vanquish beaters. Ooh. If you guys don't have one of these Vanquish beaters, get one. Fucking extremely high quality beater. It's a large, I put it in the dryer, didn't really shrink that much, still fucking fits. Like, this is probably prime ideal wife beater. Trust me, I've worn wife beaters before, some people make them. I'm not gonna name who. but some people make them way too fucking narrow to the point where it's like double XL doesn't fit my ass. Let me tell you, I'm big, but I ain't that fucking big. Double XL should fit my ass, right? I'm a large guy. If a large doesn't fit me, it's too fucking small. So this is perfect. Guys, whenever you're in doubt and you have no tracks to listen to, you go Echo. You go Echo.
Go on. Like that. Let's go. Come on. Let's go. There we go. Come on.
That shit going on with P. Diddy. This guy that I follow, apparently he was his like trainer. He trained him at his house and shit. And he posted on Instagram that like he saw shit that like P. Diddy apparently was doing at his house, and like he didn't agree with what he was doing. And like P. Diddy and his team were like threatening him, saying like, if you try to fucking come out and expose anyone in Hollywood about what you've seen in this house or whatever, I'm gonna have you and your family killed and shit. And apparently he's had his Instagram like mysteriously deleted like 6 times or some shit. Deleted just out of nowhere.
Well, P. Diddy's security guard said he saw P. Diddy do shit, all this stuff. And another security guard says he's a psychopath maniac. And he saw him shoot a guy in the head, P. Diddy, like in a room, like it's just like hitman style. Like,
I'm surprised P. Diddy's security would not know like that.
Huh? X security.
But isn't he scared of like just getting killed right now? Like, what does he have to benefit from?
He's supposed to be screwed. He's the next R. Kelly.
But it's crazy. Like, why does it all come out at once? Like, why now? It's like they wanted to come out now.
It's like, I think it's his contract's over, G.
Didn't Eminem say that P. Diddy killed Tupac?
Yeah.
As a joke, but it's really like, definitely probably real. probably fucking good.
Dude, everyone around him dies except for P. Diddy.
It's crazy though. If I was like his security, I'd be scared to even say anything. I'd be like, fuck, this guy's gonna fucking shoot my mom or something in the fucking head. If I saw him literally shoot someone in the fucking head, just like point blank, like execution style, even if all the information's out against him, he's already on trial and he's probably about to go to jail. I'm not gonna come out of my way and like give info. I'd be scared that motherfucker has some fucking psycho ass cousin come and fucking slit my mom's throat. Hey, the fucking psychopaths are the craziest ones.
And he's an egomaniac, supposedly.
Gonna get 15 reps. Shoulders back, fists out. Let's go. Cool, look at that. Boom. See that? If you don't have one of those, you're fucking skinny. I'm not at least 201 right now with my clothes and shoes on. I'm gonna kill myself.
Oh my god. Oh, it feels good to be alive, baby.
It feels good to be alive. Look at my fat stomach. You guys wanna see a fucking gunt? Fat, hairy gunt? Look at that fucking gunt. It's all right, guys. Feel free to fat shame me in the comments. Bullying's allowed on this channel, you know, if it's directed towards me, Brandon, Bashar, you know, feel free to bully. This is a bully positive environment. We encourage bullying, you know, because bullying drives motivation. Motivation drives results. Without a proper amount of bullying in life, you probably get nowhere. If there's no shit talkers, there's no motivation to get anything done. It's called putting some fucking gas in the tank, man. You know, have you ever started a fire without gasoline? There's some fucking matches? I think so.
Oh, fucking shit.
Yeah, look at that, guys. Talk your shit, boy. Talk your shit. the person with the best fat chirp in the comments below is getting pinned. Give me your best fat chirp. Chubby Checker, Fat Filipino. Name this hashtag Bully Bernardo. Don't mention anything about my small dick, guys. That's really insecure about that. You know what these stools are actually made for, guys? See the hole in the middle? This is a golden shower stool. You put this in the shower, you lay under it while your shorty pisses through that fucking hole on your mouth. It's a golden shower stool. You guys know. Lay under that stool, you know?
That'd be such a dream. I'd be so happy. I'm not joking in a weird ass fucking way. If my girl ever just sits on that.
No, that's what it's for.
If I ever just sit on that and then we're just both fucking horny and bricked up and she's like, oh my God, ready? And I'm like, yeah. And she just pisses.
What if she shits through that hole?
Oh, no, that's too
funny. You want her to shit through it?
No.
Well, why else do you think there's a hole there? Seriously, show them the hole.
I showed them the fucking hole, dude.
Guys, why do you think there would be a hole in the middle? No, seriously, why do you think there would be a fucking hole in the middle of the stool? Clearly a golden shower stool.
That is weird though, like, why is there a hole?
Where you can sit on it, right? And, like, the girl sits on it. Or maybe you could sit on it. The girl's underneath just eating your butthole.
Or you put, like, a dildo. And the girl sits on it.
Oh, and you fuck your asshole with it, Brandon?
Huh?
You fuck your own ass
with it. Yeah, yeah.
The dildo attachment right there. Guys, what would you do if you came home and you saw Brandon with a dildo attached right here where this hole is? And he's just absolutely sitting on it, like,
ew.
and he's moaning and choking himself.
That's crazy.
Brandon thinks no one's home and shit.
Holy shit.
Brandon thinks no one's home. He thinks I'm at Olivia's, Nathan's somewhere, but like no one's home. There's a dildo here, and Brandon's just fucking naked, just choking himself at the time, just fucking his own ass.
I think that's the worst thing you've ever seen in your life.
What would you do if I caught you doing that?
What would I do?
Yeah, if I caught you doing
it. Yeah, I was actually going hard.
And you're like, your eyes are rolling back, and you're like moaning.
Oh my God. I would get up and just like jump on my bed. I would jump on my bed and just be like so embarrassed. Oh. I would be frozen. Imagine you did that, but you weren't.
that is. I think that's like saying, imagine if you sucked a dick, but you weren't.
So tell me a story where. He has a girlfriend. His girlfriend puts a strap on and fucks him.
He's imagining it's a guy. You're simulating it.
And supposedly he never really fucks her. Puts a strap on and fucks him.
Maybe this is what they do here. Maybe this goes in there. Like under and inside there. It smells like shit. And then after you use the paper towels and wipe it off. Clean up the scene of the crime with a towel and then just put it back. But the thing is, Brandon's such a freak, he wouldn't use a towel to clean this off. You just suck it off.
Yeah, that's enough. I got shit, dude. Get the fuck out of here.
What'd you do, Brandon, if you came home and Nathan was ailing himself at that? And then you caught him sucking it off.
I wouldn't even say anything. I wouldn't even talk about it. It'd be way too embarrassed. I'd be so mad at myself, like, why'd I walk in? Why?
I would love that if I saw that.
Your whole life would be ruined.
I'd be like,
trust me, bro. If you saw Nathan doing that, your life would be ruined for sure. You'd be so traumatized.
Guys, we're such bozos. We literally were chirping all the traffic on the way here. We're like, oh my God, look, there's an accident. It was a crazy accident. Everybody was just stuck in traffic. It was like dead still traffic. And then we're like, make sure we don't go this way home. We don't want to get stuck in the same traffic. What do we know? We're not even thinking, we're just shooting the shit, talking about all that, you know, crazy stuff we're talking about in the gym. And now we found ourselves back in the... Oh, I thought he was getting us thinking, fucking texting and driving or some fucking shit. I was ready to fucking have full explanation, ready to go. I'm like, hey buddy, I got two hands on the wheel and he's filming me, buddy.
I got nervous, it's like parents always make you feel so scared and turn the lights in your car.
Oh, you thought it was because the lights were on in the car?
Because now your parents always think it's like some fucked up shit.
Guys, turn the lights off in the car, we're gonna get pulled over.
Yeah, and we always think that shit.
They're like fucking, then we see some weird shit. Yeah, you're right. Guys, just as we're driving there, the cop literally just, we're on the highway by the way. Cop just stepped out in front of our car from the shoulder there and was flashing a flashlight dead ass in our face, telling us to stop. And I was like, oh great, we're getting pulled over right now by a cop on foot. I guess there was a car pulled over or something, and he was just trying to get him out of the shoulder. Oh shit! How many more times do you think you'll cough before you die? How many more
coughs do you think you have?
Thousands.
You know, your heart only has a certain number of beats. Once it hits that number,
yeah.
That's why I think, like, you know the marathon runners, like the ultra marathon runners?
Yeah, they're killing themselves.
You know how you know how the resting heart rate goes down to, like, 30 beats per minute, though?
Yeah.
And, like, the average is, like, 60 to 100 or something?
Yeah.
I think their body compensates, right? So they're doing such long distance running and their heartbeat's always so high while they're running. It's like boom, 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 boom. That is now it compensates because it only has a certain number of beats.
Oh, yeah.
So now when you're resting, it's like, oh shit, if we don't lower the resting heart rate now and
we
keep it at normal, the heart, like, we're going to die earlier. You know what I mean? So now we have to lower the heart rate when it's resting to make up for the amount that it's beating while we're fucking running for hours on end. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's definitely it.
I think that's what it is. That your body knows, I only have X million amount of beats.
The body knows how to balance that stuff out.
I need to balance myself out right now. You know what I mean?
So deep down, your heart knows you're going to die.
I think that's what it is. It has to be. You know what I mean? So it's like, if you're not an ultra marathon runner, you know, like that, and you're not putting your heart through that, then your heart rate's just going to be fucking average. I could be completely wrong with that. I don't know.